Yes. Yeah, I once again welcome the lecture series of electric power quality. So, you know that this is the 39th class. We are discussing all the things. So, but out of this 39, we are spending nearly 10 classes. So, nearly 500 minutes to the 600 minutes for revising all the things and at all. We're already revised, I mean, third time also, some topics thought to four time we are already revised. So now next, we'll go for the some another topics what we are left from the fifth chapter and as well as the sixth chapter. Okay, so now we know that we are in the fifth chapter called distribution, distributed generation and power quality. This is very important one nowadays. The more research is going on this one. So you know that in the recent, if you have any interested to read some articles and generals and technological papers, you know, you heard that some names, you read that already some names, microgrids and smart grids. All that comes under this umbrella, nothing but distributed generation. Okay, how this one? Now see this, we are already discussed. So what are the different types of distributed generation and power qualities, and what are the different pieces, technologies available in right now? Then what is the interference to the utility system? What are the problems while we are facing interference or interface with these diseases to the distributed systems? So all other things. Then how to impact the power calls? You know that we are already discussed four different types. So some interruption, some voltage regulation, as well as some harmonics, as well as voltage sags. So to improve the power quality. So this disease will help to increase the power quality by means of four ways. First one is the sustained interruptions, and the second one is the voltage regulations, and third one is the harmonics, and fourth one is the voltage sags. We are already discussing that one of that. That is the power quality issues while arising at the same time while decreasing by using this DGs. So next, we have to see the operating conditions, a very important one. So I say that it is very simply to interface. I already said that. So if we are interfacing these DGs to the distribution system, so we simply what I said, it simply matches the frequency as well as voltage. There are a lot of other conflicts is also there while interfacing this disease to the distribution systems. Now we are going to discuss all these things. So the first, remember, the main one is we have to synchronize with the grid that must matches the frequency as well as voltage levels. Remember, must matches the frequency level, first thing. Otherwise, you are not interfacing any other sources to that feeder or nothing but a distribution feeder or grid, whatever it may be. We are simply got as local grid. So local grid or distribution feeders. So it matches the frequency. So beyond that one, there are so many another operating conflicts is also there while interfacing or while adding these digits to the distribution systems. Now we are going to discuss all the things. This is very important one, as well as in the topics we are going to discuss here. Okay, now we'll share that to you. Now see this. So we are in 39th class. So now see this, what are the different operating conflicts we are going to discuss? We know that you have different types of operating conflicts. What are the different types? Now see this, these are the some of the operating conflicts while interfacing or while connecting this gauges to the system. So this is a VS. We are talking about this one, sending an voltage. This is the we are receiving an voltage. Now here in this side we are connecting some DG. For suppose DG, you know that what is DG? DG is less than 10 megawatt and connected to the load location. So we can call it as DG. So VS and this is the VS sending an voltage. This is the receiving an voltage. So nothing but the loads. Loads. We are connecting the loads here. This side we are connecting this DG. Now while interface this DG or while connecting this DG, it must matches the frequency is the primary or main parameter is to matches the frequency, then voltages and then current. So when whenever these are matching, we are synchronizing this DG with this feeder, this feeder. That may be have this VS may be of substation, whatever it may be. Substation or whatever it may be. We are not at all thinking this VS means any generator and all other things. We are considered whenever we are seen in load way, load side way. So we are considering the substation and your source. You're not an issue. Okay. So, you understand what I'm saying? So now see this this DG. So whenever you are matching this quantity, once that quantities are matched, okay, this frequency, voltage and currents, so we are interfacing this into this feeder into this feeder or local grid, whatever it may be. Once it is synchronized, what will happen here is yes, the second phase is coming. This is the first phase. Then what is the second phase? Protection. Second phase is the protection. First one is if you are willing to synchronize with this local grid, once it is done, after that we are thinking about this protection. Okay, thinking about this protection. What is this one? So how to protect, and what are the conflicts while you are getting while operating this this disease. So this is the main important thing, very important thing. So this we will get in some another way. This we will get in another more positive way. Then only will continue to operate our diseases to the systems. Remember, whenever you are this protection scheme, whenever you are maintaining this protection scheme very thoroughly, then only we are operating this DG some efficient way. So now see this, what are the protection schemes affected, or what are the measures while you are going to follow based on the protection way. So for this disease and other things we are going to see here. So there are some different types of operating conflicts are arising while you are operating this disease to this feeders. The first one is the utility fault clearing requirements. So what are the clearing requirements and all other things. The next one is the reclosing. So what is meant by reclosing? That means so the closing of the circuit breakers and lighting arresters and all other than relaying and all other equipments are also treated as a reclosing. So then how it will be causes some problems, or how it will be interference with this relaying. So how it will be affect the operations while you are interfacing this disease to this feeder. Then what is regulation issues. Then we are already discussed these two voltage regulation issues and as well as harmonics based on this disease. So then this what is islanding effect, what is ferroresonance as well as. So what is the effect of shunt capacitance while you are interfacing this disease to this system. You know that this is also very important topic here. This all are important, but this one is also one of the important. So why? Because in the load side only we are connecting this capacitors. capacitors also. The load side, we are connecting this capacitors also. Now see this, how these capacitors will impact the, how these DGs will impact the capacitor operation and all other things. How to, because of this DG interaction with this capacitor, how the performance of this DG will change. So, or otherwise, then capacitor effect, how this DG will react, so vice versa. Then all other things we are going to discuss. So then as well as transformer connections. You know that this DG is connected in the load side. So load side, you have some transformer. Definitely you have some transformer. This transformer. Yes, this transformer is connected in different ways. Star, delta, star as well as delta. Delta to star, star to star connection. So we have different combinations is there, some start to ground as well as delta. So different combinations of this transformer connections are there. So how this DGs will impact the based on the transformer connections to the transformers. So other things we are going to discuss. That's why I am saying out of this the entire syllabus, nothing but this topics what we are already discussing. This operating conflicts is very important one in research way. Remember, in research way, in research way, this is very important one. Okay, what we already discussed, nothing but DG technology. Those are already existed. You just yes, simply say that you have some solar panels in our household. Also, we are using some solar. But you are not bothering about all the things. But as an electrical engineer, you have to know this one. What are the operating problems while you are, synchronized with this grid. This is synchronized with this grid. You have to know that. You have to analyze as an electrical engineer. You have to analyze because in every household also, in the rooftop of the our households, we are simply installing these DGs. Nothing but solar cells or solar panels. Okay, but they want any bother about this all the things what we are discussing right now. So they just install and given some smart meter. They put a some smart meter and that is synchronized with this grid. So and some injecting the some voltages or it will take the some voltages from the system. So and vice versa, that is it. But as an electrical engineer, we have to know whether you are installing some DGs or whether in rapid changes occurred in the DG technologies. So most of the households are installing this solar cells. You know that one country called Norway, I think you know that. So the excessive power that will be generated by this renewable energy sources when compared to the generation power given by the government, that local government. The power is excessive when compared to the base load plants. This solar energy, renewable energy, source energy is excessive when compared to the base load. You remember one thing. So there is no such technology that without base load plants, okay, without nothing but without base load plants. What is base load plants? Is nothing but some fuels, some coal plants and nothing but thermal plants as well as nuclear plants. So we are not at all operating only based on this renewable energy sources energy. Remember, because these are the not a base load plants. Okay, in some countries they are facing these problems also. Excessive energy while compared to the base loads. So because they are facing some problems on that one also, because they are every households they are generating power. So and every household they can inject that power into the grid. What will happen here? Excessive amount of source of energy is generated. So there are some complexities also there. So as an electrical engineer, you have to see this. So what are the protection equipments? What are the protective equipments while you are going to follow while installing this DG into the grid? Okay, then we are see that first one will be utility fault clearing requirements. Very important one in this cases. Or see this In the last class also, we already discussed, but in depth you can see this. So utility fault clearing requirements. You know that this is the substation. You can assume this. This is a substation. VS. VS is the substation. Yes, I slightly say that this is the substation. This is the substation. This is the transformer. This is the substation. This is the transformer. So this is the transformer. So I'm not saying that this what is the connection of this transformer start to delta, delta. So, but let us assume this is the transformer. First of all, transformer. So these are the feeders, feeder 1, feeder 2, and feeder 3. These are the three feeders. Can anyone say this? Why? One substation, it has different feeders. You know that? The main reason is cost, reduction of the cost. One substation, we have, but suppose we have only one feeder, but one substation, it has 3 to 4 feeders and more than that feeders also. You know the main reason? Because of the cost. Cost is the main reason. So that's why only one substation we are making in our India is also like this. So treated it as some Indian system. So in one substation, you have different feeders, 3 to 4 feeders as there because based on the cost, economical way. So now see this, out of this, different types, so feeder 1, feeder 2, and feeder 3. Out of these three feeders, so you know that any substation it has the protective equipment. So all these feeders we are going to connect some loads, different types of loads. So these feeders will connected by the loads here. So suppose these are the loads. For suppose loads. Different loads. For our simplicity purpose, we just only assume the feeder 3. Remember, for the simplicity's purpose, we just only assume the feeder 3. These are the loads, different loads. Okay, you know that what is the protective equipment? What is the protection scheme? It says that. What is the protection scheme? It says that. So here, we are discussing work and protection scheme. A work and protection scheme, what it says there, work and protection scheme, whenever there are some certain levels, so how this work and protection, how this work and is producing, this is because of the short circuit problem. So you know that there are different ways of getting this short circuits. So first suppose, so there is some short circuit fault will present in this feeder 3. First suppose feeder 3. What will happen here? What is the lowest level component protective equipment? You know that? What is the lowest level component protective equipment? Is the fuse. Fuse, then after the circuit breakers. Okay, the, what is the lowest level component to protect the system is the fuse. So you know that whenever there is a power current is passing on the feeder, a fuse is pumped, a fuse is melted. So at that fuse melting time, on that time only, it takes some time to melt that fuse. Some amount of power. Yes, this is the first protective equipment to protect the system. If it it's operating, the fuse is operating time is very high. So then it will come to the reclosers. This is the recloser. You know that what is the recloser? Circuit breaker. Recloser is one of the, this is also one of the CB circuit breaker. This is the circuit breaker. This is also the CB circuit breaker. This is also another circuit breaker. So which one clears the fault? A circuit breaker is see this. The only device must operate to create the fault is a reclosure. Okay, reclosures as switches, simply as switches, reclosures, switches, different categories are circuit breakers and other things. Okay, so now see this Voron production. So because of this this any of the loads are external fault, you know that because of external faults and failures, so short circuit problem is arise in this field. The first protective equipment is the field. If it so then after it goes to the reclosure, and reclosure is clear the fault. So this will happen in the substation side, nothing but the distribution side. Simply a distribution. This is the distribution network. First of all, this is the distribution network. Distribution network. So once as we already discussed in the power quality, so because of this opening time also, there are some fault currents entering in the system also. So okay, whatever, we are not going in that way, but see here, so the fuse, so then you can see this first one is fuse, then after reclosure or circuit. This is the step we are going to come. Then after some substation equipment, some substation, then after come to the transmission. This is the way. So this is distribution side. This is the distribution side. This is the transmission side. The production equipment is coming from the customer to the generation plant. You know that in some different way, you know that the only single protection scheme is not sufficient for all the devices at the same time. So there are different protection schemes are allowed based on the distributions, based on the characteristics of the customers, characteristics of the loads and different categories. You know that the distribution protection scheme is not allowed to protect the transmission as well as the generating plants, because in the distribution side, the voltage levels and current levels are changes very rapidly. But in generating plants, nearly generating a generator, that a small amount of change in voltage and currents is also very effective to that generator. So the protection schemes that we follow from the distribution, transmission, as well as the generation changes. Okay, now see this. This type of protection schemes are available in the substation. So now our DGs, distributed generating plants, or DGs are installed this side. Remember this side. So these are the protective equipments available in the substation. Now we are going to, what is DC? DC means here, those are installed in the load locations, near to the load location. These are the loads. Now these are the productive schemes available in the nature, available in the power systems. But here we are only discussed about the Voron. There are different types of production schemes are there. Okay, war voltage production is there, war plant production is there, earth fault release is there, different types of production schemes are there. So this type of, we are discussing only one type here. This war plant production scheme is available in the substation. This type of substations are feeders. We are going to install our DG. Yes, we are going to install our DG. First of all, DG. Now we can see this. How these DGs will interact with this protective system? How does what is the behavior of these DGs while getting any problems in this feeder? You understand what is the behavior of these DGs while getting any problems in this feeder, or what is the protection schemes is used to protect this feeder? So if this same protection scheme is able to protect the DG or not, or suppose there is any problems arised in the DG side, now we will see that whether this protective scheme is available protection scheme of this feeder is going to protect this feeder or not. There are so many conflicts are there. This is the important conflict here. How these DGs will interact, how these diseases will act according to this protective scheme. You can see in both way. Okay, in fader way, what is the protection scheme? In DG side, what is the protection scheme? Fader is placing, fader is creating some form. Then you can see the what is the DG effect, or when DG is creating some fault. Now you can see the what is the fader effect. So how this fader will affect based on this DG fault, or fader is creating some fault. Now you can see this how this DG will face this fault because of this fader. Okay, all the things we are going to discuss here. Okay, so now see this. We are discussing some protective schemes and other things. Remember, substation side, substation to the load side. Remember, these protection schemes. What we are discussing in the coming topics and other things in the substation to the load side. Remember, substation to the load side because of DGs are installed this way. Some load side only. But suppose there are any fault in the transmission system and generation. So it must have at least two breakers to operate to clear these faults. Now see this point importantly. The DC device must independently detect the fault. Remember this DC. This device is independently detect the fault and separate to allow the utility protection system to complete the clearing isolation process. What does this mean? What is the meaning of this point? So whenever there is some fault in this fader, or there are some fault clearing equipments are there, fault identifying equipments are there. What is the fault identifying equipments? So what a fuse? You know that fuse is the fault identifying. Nothing but if there is any work on this passing, and this fuse will melt. This is a fault identifying as well as clearing equipment. Then another one is relays. This relays will helpful to detect the fault and give it to the information to the circuit breakers, and according to that circuit breakers will operate. But at the same time, this DG side also, this DG will also have these some own protection scheme. Okay, two-way protection is very important one. We are not taking light as fader is protecting the fader has the protection scheme, so that's why we are not at all eliminating DC protection scheme here. The thing is so we have to maintain separately two different protection schemes. Nothing but a fader, we have the separate protection scheme. At the same time, the DC is also, it has its own protection scheme. So this DC will also near here. This point means this DC will also independently knows that which type of fault is arisen in the feeder. Okay, then only that operation is going to success. Nothing but whenever the fault is clearing very accurately. Okay, so DC protection scheme is separate. At the same time, so substation protection, nothing but this fader 3 protection scheme is separately we have to maintain. Okay, see this second one. What is the reclosing? Very important. So, nothing but where reclosing equipments and where you can connect these DGs, where the DGs must be disconnected from the distribution feeder, or where this DG is again reconnected to this feeders and all other things. We are going to discuss this point. Okay, see this reclosing. So the second one in operating complex, the second one reclosing. Now we are already seeing that utility, then see that reclosing. What is that reclosing? Now see this, there are two special problems with respect to this disease. Now, what is this two main things? Diseases must disconnect early in this reclose interval to allow time for the R to dissipate so that the reclose will be successful. This is first one. Important points. These two are very important points. So here, now see this diagram. This DZ will disconnect here only. This DZ will disconnect here in this interval only. It's reclosing of this interval. It is not maintaining up to this one because to eliminate the R, you know that. So the contacts of the circuit breakers and recloses, there's much amount of arc is produced because of that opening and at the same time closing time. So whether DZ is connected on that arcing, you know that arc based on that arc also the continuously maintaining the power. That current is maintained continuously based on that arc. So we have to protect our DZs from this faults. So before that clearing interval, this interval, our DZ must be disconnected before the dissipation of the arc. Remember, so first suppose two contacts is there. See this, two contacts is there, contact A and B. So this is the reclosing. First suppose this is the reclosing. Then arc is produced. You know that arc, then arc is produced. So there is some problem here. So can change the line. So in the normal interval, it is running this way. There is a problem is happened. So this one of the contact is open like this. So on that process, it will produce some arc. So that means, so it will still connected to this contact B. So what will happen? So still connected in this arcing period only. So DZs may get damaged. So that's why. So before this this completion of this arcing time, the DZs must be, our DZ must be open. The next one. So what is the second point? Important point is here reclosing on DZ, particularly those systems using rotating machines technologies can cause damage to the generator or primary. You know that very well. So if you still maintaining this DZs to the systems, it may damage the DZs. Suppose DZ we have the some generators, small generators and all other things we consider, not the solar cells and solar panels and all other things. For suppose we are making small generator or wind generator, small hydel plants, local hydel plants, what will happen in that case? Emissions that may damage. Yes, because so before the opening, so this is the reason behind that one, before the clearing of that one, dissipation of that recloser, so you must disconnect this one. So at the same time, DZs will also detect that fault. Yes, see this, DZs, now see this part, DZs must be able to detect the presence of the fault. Okay, so because the substation, now see this diagram, because the substation protection scheme is very busy with protecting this feeder. Okay, so that's why a separate protection mechanism is mandatory for the DZ to protect their own cell. So that's why DZ relaying must be can put into the system so that DZ protection scheme will detect that fault and clear that fault before this feeder. This is the feeder. So this is the DZ side. So DZ side protection. So we have the protection scheme of this DZ. Then only before the arc clearing, arc dissipation. So on that time only you can detect that fault and you can disconnect from that system. Otherwise, what will happen? You have no separate equipments, protection equipment, still maintaining this DZ. So that may lead to damage to our systems. So that's why our DZ also separate system. So this DZ, so whenever this fault is present in the system, our DZ also detect that fault and immediately disconnect from the system. Okay, so here now see this where here then first reclosing interval only. You know that in our power system, the power, the voltage and current rating changes very rapidly time to time based on the time. You know that based on the season as well as based on the time, 24 hours time, as well as based on the day, as well as based on the season, at the summer as well as winter, rainy seasons, based on the power usage changes. So, you know, by considering 24 hours time, especially in household customers, not the industrial, you know that industrial customers, the loads are constantly updating. But when coming to the customers like us, so domestic customers and as well as some commercial customers, like small complexes, shopping complexes and other things. So the amount of power usage is changing time to time. So and the time, so you know that, so you know that protection scheme as a protection to engineer is going to protect the all the equipment. But because of changing a small amount of voltages and currents, what will happen here? This relay will detect that the small amount of changes in voltage and currents will give it the information to the circuit breakers and circuit breakers working. So you know where to maintain in the constant power. We are doing like this. So that's why plus or minus 10% of voltage is allowable. That's why we can maintain this one. So this protective engineering is keep it in mind that so this voltage, this level of voltage is available to operate the system. But as our power quality engineer, this 10% voltage is also impact our systems. Okay. Okay. Now see this year, the first reclose interval for the purpose of improving power quality to the sensitive customers. Now this, you know, this is one point. So at the first interval, reclosing interval only here, this only, not this one. Remember, here two types is there, one as well as two. This reclosing interval only, our DC must be disconnected in order to protect the sensitive equipments and in order to maintain the power quality. So now see this, what are the intervals, timing intervals of this reclosings, and then what is the time for opening the DCs and other things we are going to see here. See, the time for instantaneous reclose is normally 0.5 seconds, but can be fast as 0.2 seconds to protect the equipments. So 0.5 seconds to the 0.2 seconds. So at the same time, we have to maintain, this is the range of relaying and operating time for some DC breakers also. You know that DC have the, some separate protection mechanism. But remember this point, instantaneous remember, in some times, this instantaneous reclosing time, 0.5 seconds, in some cases 0.2 seconds, very small time, this instantaneous times, sometimes it may be incompatible with the DC, because it increases the probability that some DCs will still connect to the reclosers. Because the reclosers has a sufficient time here to clear this arcing and all other things. So that's why here this point, a reclose interval at least 0.1 second is safer when there is a DC on the feeder. So a reclose interval, how much time is there? Reclose interval, how much interval is there? So 0.1 seconds at least time is to maintain to operate the feeder. So some intervals they are maintaining 2 to 5 seconds. First reclose interval when the DC is installed, this is the time to maintain the this is the allowable time to disconnect the DC from systems and algorithms. So here you can see this. So this time based on the Remember, this times is not at all fixed. Remember, this times is not at all fixed. You just assume one case. You just assume one case. Because nowadays we have very advanced equipments are there. Some artificial intelligence based relaying as well as predictive equipments are there. They are very they are estimating the occurrence of the faults also some damages. Some they are estimating, but they are not mandatory saying that. But there are some estimation is also there nowadays technology. So that's why most of the way you can call it as a smart grids. Remember smart grid. The smart grid means not only the how smartly you can connect this system to the grid. At the same time, how smartly you can protect the some faults from the DGs as well as the grid. That is the smart grid. Okay, technological based, so much technology is involved in this process. These are operating process and all other things. So this this smart grid concept is coming, our microgrid concept is coming based on this DGs and all other things. Okay, so here I'm not saying this, these are the constant, but according to our textbook, these are the rating they can give in the sample rating. Remember, these are the sample ratings they can give in based on the time 1990s understand. So here the concept meaning is here. There are some much available time is available to open the DGs. At the same time, DG must be disconnect the system at the first reclosure interval. Otherwise, we may get some problems, or we may face some problems. DG will face some problems. So these are this is the second operating conflict, reclosing, where that when our DG will be open. And nothing but disconnect from the system. This is the second. Then third one is also there. What is the third one? Because of the relaying, how this DGs will impact the interference with the operation of this DG, the operation of this relay, and all other things. Maybe we are going to discuss in next class. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for joining today's class. Thank you very much.